ACEs, which is Adverse Childhood Experiences on Learning, suggests that kids who are acting out need to discuss what has happened to them with a caring adult. School social work positions have been cut back since the recession. What are your plans to increase the number of school social workers and counselors available to troubled students?
Well, one initiative that we've had here is, in addition to providing additional training for our clinical staff, we've also started training our classroom teachers and other adults or staff members who work directly with children with some of those trauma-informed strategies. Obviously, trauma-informed care is not necessarily a clinical approach. However, there are strategies and interventions that, once trained, that any responsible adult can provide some effective support and feedback to a student who may be experiencing trauma.
And if I could just interject also, in the years that I've been at this level and even before as director of middle school, so we have not reduced our school social worker staffing here in Escambia County. In addition to that, we have we continue to hire additional staff. We have certified behavior analysts that that work and support our schools to help the staff at the schools be better prepared, again, to work with students that exhibit extreme behaviors. We are adding a certified behavior analyst position to support the eye care program next year, but that person is going to focus on providing resources to schools, to elementary schools that have students that are having difficulty adjusting, to try to help that student remain at that school by providing strategies and supports for those students at their elementary school. So that's a preventive approach to try to prevent that student from being referred to an alternative program.
Can I answer? We also employ more than 22 behavior coaches in our schools, and they work closely with the behavior analysts and our behavior team that we have through the ESC department. The intention of those behavior coaches is to work on proactive strategies with children, so making those connections, not having to be reactive after behaviors occur, but to really try to get ahead of that, so that they're trying to help students adjust better, and maybe we can reduce some of the behavioral issues that we've seen in schools.
I was going to add that our two largest middle schools were able to add a third counselor last school year, and many of the middle schools are looking at using some of their funding, their Title I funding and their SAI funding, to have an RTI or MTSS coach for this coming school year, so that they're able to better meet some of the needs of the children. Many of the schools also designate a unit for the positive behavioral support coach for that as well, again, so that they can do some of that trauma-informed care as well.